who was the counterparty to this gold coin? God. And who is the counterparty to this? The government. Who do you trust? Well, I looked up how much is a trillion? If you took, you spent a dollar a minute, it would take you 32,000 years to spend $1 trillion. 32,000 years. It takes them 1 minute to print $1 trillion. But for the last so many years, since 1907, really, they've been saving the banks. So the banks are so corrupt, and the reason the Federal Reserve had to come in was to protect the rich bankers. And what they did was back in 2008, there was quantitative easing, which is a very complex subject. But basically, the Fed just prints money and gives it to banks, okay, to prevent them from failing. So that's not capitalism. That's Marxism. That's socialism. That's communism. It's called central banks. But since most of our school teachers are communists anyway, they don't know the difference. So they can't teach kids that. So what happened in 1971, President Nixon then took the dollar off the gold standard. And so that they could print as much money as they wanted to. And in 1972, I was flying behind enemy lines as a Marine pilot, and I went to look for gold. So this here is gold. This is God's money. Gold and silver are God's money. They're parts of the periodic table of elements. So there's really, I think this is 47 and gold and silver 74 or something, but I flunked chemistry also. This is real money. And this here is a Zimbabwe dollar. And this is $10 billion. This may as well be the US dollar. So what the Fed is trying to do is print tons of debt, like I think 10 trillion this year, to prevent the banks from failing. So they need inflation because they want to pay back the debt with Zimbabwe dollars. Just think about that. So they can inflate the debt, print 10 trillion, then they print, here's a $10 billion. This might have bought you an egg when it was good, a boiled egg. So they could pay off the debt with fake money. That's where I wrote the book Fake and all this stuff. So anyway, the reason inflation is going to wipe out people is because the average person is a consumer. So they go, everybody talks about, I want to, you know, T-bone steak is this now and gasoline's this and toilet paper's that and all this. But that's because Biden and company and the Fed are protecting the bankers. Everything's to protect the bankers. So that's why I feel for the working class people. I think it's criminal that our school system is part of Marxism. There's no financial education in schools, and it's not a mistake. So I've been saying this since, my first book was, if you want to be rich and happy, don't go to school. This was long before Rich Dad Poor Dad. But today we can see what's happened. But anyway, it's all BS. So the people who are complaining about inflation just know it's because the Federal Reserve Bank, the U.S. Treasury, which is Janet Yellen, who was also head of the Federal Reserve Bank, they're as corrupt as they come. They're communists, and we worship them. This is what's sad. You see, this is gold. This is real security. It's God's money. So is silver, and so is Bitcoin due to the blockchain technology. I'm not saying buy any of this stuff. I'm just telling you why I own this. So this is real money. I mean, I can travel anywhere in the world. Its value goes up and down as it's manipulated, and I can spend it. But what this is, the Zimbabwe dollar, is fake money. And the only way this comes into existence is an entrepreneur like me creates an asset. You know, Rich Dad Poor Dad is about assets versus liabilities. So I go into BlackRock and I say, guess what? I have a startup here. You know, I mean, Tesla or something. And Tesla is now a $1 trillion company. But what happens if GM, and you know, Biden doesn't like Tesla, I can tell. But let's say that GM comes out with an electric car that you can buy for $2. Tesla's toast. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
But so much of the stock market is based upon the valuation of a company like Tesla, or like the earlier thing, you know, Netflix or Blockbuster Video. So much of it is you don't know what's called the counterparty to it. The only counterparty to this is God. God made this. And silver, God made this. And the Bitcoin is blockchain. That's what gives Ethereum and blockchain. So some people ask me, I'm Satoshi, so I don't speak Japanese. But I don't know anything about blockchain, but I just don't trust this. I don't trust the US dollar. I don't trust the Fed. I don't trust the Treasury, and I don't trust our government, and I don't trust Wall Street. If you do, invest your ass off. But what they're doing is they're creating what I call a fake asset. This is a Zim dollar. It's no difference than a US dollar or a US stock or a US bond. And so that's why you don't find me saving dollars. I save gold, silver, Bitcoin. And it could change. You know, I mean, Bitcoin could become obsolete also. But the reason I listen to guys like Anthony Pompliano and all the smart young guys is they'll give me early warning if something's going to come up. So you got to pay attention to what YouTube is saying. But ladies and gentlemen, you've really got to be smarter today. And that's why the Rich Dad Company was founded. We don't sell stocks or bonds or mutual funds or gold. You know, we just sell awareness, be aware of what's happening. That's the biggest thing. One more thing about this fake billion. I mean, what is it? You know, toilet paper is worth more than this. I say this often when I looked up how much is a trillion. If you spent a dollar a minute, it would take you 32,000 years to spend $1 trillion. 32,000 years. It takes them 1 minute to print $1 trillion. So they're coming up with this infrastructure problem and all this. And this is what we study at Rich Dad. It used to be if you printed, let's say, $1 million, the GDP rose by 1,000,010. Today you print $1 million, the GDP only comes up by 7. In other words, we're going further and further in debt. We cannot pay off the debt. And so what they're doing, they print more money, hoping to pay off that debt. It just makes the debt bigger and this piece of toilet paper worth less. But just remember, I'm coming out with my latest book. It's called The Capitalist Manifesto, and it goes into this. It's how our school system is Marxist. They're communists. My family are Marxists. They don't know it. They're good people, but they believe in giving people fish. I believe in teaching people to fish. And the other thing is the Fed is Marxist. So if you understand how communism has infiltrated America, that's why I wrote the Capitalist Manifesto. You can be a communist if you want. You can be a Marxist if you want. Your choice. And that's why Rich Dad was founded, you know, way back when. You know, before it was Rich Dad Poor Dad, my first book is Find Me Rich and Happy, Don't Go to School, because most school teachers are Marxists. They just don't know. They believe in giving people fish rather than teaching people to fish. So we at Rich Dad teach, and that's why I have guys like John McGregor and all the other advisors, Kenny McElroy. You know, we teach. We don't tell people what to do. Who is the counterparty to this gold coin? God. And who's the counterparty to this? The government. Who do you trust? Who's the counterparty to Bitcoin? Blockchain. It's people's money. I trust the people more than the government. And that's why I support Bitcoin. Could I be wrong? Possibly, you know. This gold here is as liquid as they come. I can go anywhere in the world and somebody will give me money for it. Anywhere. But real estate? No. S&P 500 is liquid. This is liquid. And so is cash liquid. It's called financial literacy. What's the vocabulary of money? So one vocabulary word today is counterparty risk. Who is the counterparty risk on this gold U.S. Eagle? God, not the U.S. government. Who is the counterparty on the Zimbabwe dollar?